Have you ever wondered, what is the brain? Where does it start and end? What's it made of? How does it vary across species? To learn more, I asked an expert.
The brain is the organ located inside of your skull. That's the central command for your body. It processes input from your senses, it gives you thoughts, it helps control your digestion and sleep, and so much more. Your brain is part of your central nervous system, which also includes your spinal cord and the retinas inside of your eyes. You also have a peripheral nervous system, which is the nerves in the rest of your body. How you divide up the brain depends on the person you ask. Generally, the main regions of the brain include the forebrain, which also includes the cortex, the wrinkly bits on the outside, the midbrain, the brainstem, and the cerebellum. There are lots of different ways of dividing the brain up into more specific regions, including the Brodmann Atlas and the Montreal Neurological Institute Atlas.
So we know the main parts of the brain, but I want to know a little bit more, like what's inside of the brain.
You may have heard of neurons, which is what most people think of when they think of brain cells. But your brain also contains fat, fluids, blood vessels, membranes, so many different types of neurons, and non-neuron support brain cells called glia. The brain is super complicated, and it contains many different types of cells that all have different properties. Scientists from all over the world are working to understand what all those types of cells are and what their properties are, like their shape and their activity. We've identified over 5,000 different types so far, and we're working to understand them. One of the main things that people notice about the brain is the wrinkles on the outside. This is the cortex. The wrinkles are called gyri, and the valleys in between them are called sulci. These gyri and sulci are in the same basic places in all typically developing human brains. But the locations and the connections between the individual cells are unique to all of us. Everybody's brain is different.
But what about brains in other animals? Are they made of the same stuff?
We've been talking about the human brain, but lots of different animals have brains. They're all made out of the same basic parts, but not all brains have all cell types or brain parts. And the different types of cells are also different between the different species. For example, jellyfish brains are only made of neurons. They don't have glia like our brains do. Technically, they're not even brains. They're so simple, they're called neural nets. But even with such a simple nervous system, jellyfish can engage in complex behaviors like hunting, and some species even have eyes.
Sounds like there's a lot to learn when it comes to the brain. I know I have questions, like, what happens when we sleep? Is there really a difference between left brain and right brain? And what do the brains of other animals look like whales? Let me know your questions, and I will ask them to some of the world's leading scientists here at the Allen Institute.